Ow, kind of hit my knee.
I smacked my knee and then had to get surgery like a year later because it was becoming arthritic because I had a piece of cartilage floating around. My surgeon said it's way more painful than like any other knee surgery because they really, to keep it simple, they bent my knee and cut like 10 inches along my knee and split the skin and had to drill into the femur and sculpt a cadaver bone into like a cork and press it in. I have like nerve damage and shit like on the outer layer, like skin surface layer, because they had to cut so much, so it still feels weird. I've always heard that the PT is crucial and like that's really what you have to do to get better.
Fuck! Dude! I feel really bad in my groin.
It's scary when you have surgery because it's like your limb really doesn't work and you're like, fuck, is it gonna be like this forever? It's hard to imagine it being better when it's so useless for so many days in a row. When you get a surgery, you, especially on your legs, like you're not walking for a while, so your muscle atrophies really fast. Like it doesn't take very long for your muscle to completely deplete and then you're just like, and it takes a long time to build it up. So now they're getting better, but it's really hard work and really crazy workouts, shit that I've never really experienced before. But it's like cool to learn too, you know? I partially dread it, but at the same time, I don't really dread it because I'm kind of look forward to it because I know that it's like the steps to recovery and getting closer to feeling better. And being hurt sucks, so like I want to get better.
I started doing push-ups the other day. Huh? I did push-ups yesterday.
See, the arms are sore.
Yeah, I was gonna move to New York either way, I think. But I got into this school and no one from my high school in Colorado had ever gone to a school in New York City, I don't think. So like I got like a grant to come here. But I met Sean Dahlberg and he was studying film here and I started skating with him and he was like the first person I ever filmed with the VX with. It was called Mama's Boys. He put it out in like 2012, I want to say. Started filming for the first time in my life. Like before then, I'd always just skated alone. I was just so juiced on being in the city. I would just get lost and like no cell phone, just skate as much as I could because I'd come from like a small ass town in the mountains where there's not that much concrete. This is where I met Max for the first time. And this is where I would skate with like Dahlberg in between classes and stuff.
Switch ollie right now?
Yeah. Well, because like when I was a kid, seeing all the pros, there weren't like a fraction of as many like paid skateboarders when I was a kid, and everyone who was like a pro is so next level good. If I'd travel to cities who were so good and I didn't know who the fuck they were, so I'm like, if they're not pro, then I definitely won't be. I mean, that was never really my goal. But I like really lived like off the grid on some like in the mountains type shit. My mom's friend's boyfriend put me on to like a bunch of cool shit. And they had like a bunch of old comic books and like skateboards and shit. I just like became obsessed with it for some reason, despite it not really being like too available in where, like where I lived. I remember like the first year I lived here, I was buying skateboards and it was fucked. I had like a really bad run of having to buy skateboards and like snapping them on like a flat ground trick right away. Polar was like a big turning point for me because it was like the first time I'd been offered any money. That was like 2014, right when I had graduated school and I was like juggling a bunch of jobs that I hated. You didn't think that I was like trying to get sponsored when you met me, which like I wasn't really. And so like getting that offer to get paid for skating and like be on a team that was getting like, Polar was getting pretty big at that point, so it was kind of like, whoa, this is crazy, it's happening fast. And then like, it was just like too much pressure, you know? I think I was like going out to LA a lot during the winter time, like I was starting to, and like hanging out with Logan and Aiden a bunch, and they were like super down for me to do it. Like it sounded sick. It was like, Max was gonna get on and I was gonna get on. Playing in the dark without a bra. Michigan. Well, Alex obviously too, but he was more in the picture. That was like after the summer that he like destroyed shit in New York in like 3 months, filmed like a part that I think the footage was kind of like dispersed everywhere, so it didn't really ever come out as a part, but like like he filmed a lot, and that's like when he was starting the brand. So it like seemed really dope to get on. I remember the first video took a while. I mean, Aiden's part is like super long, you know? It's like 4 years or some shit. I feel like I did. I felt like I was like, oh, this is like my first video part. Like for a company or anything like that, you know? Aside from like just the homie video, which it was. It was my first like video part for anything other than a homie video. Yeah, for sure. I was like really into LA at that point. I just liked it out there. All the shit was like new to me. But then it just like took a few trips of like being stuck in the car and like striking out for me to get over it, you know? They quit, you mean? Mm-hmm. I don't know. Just like got draining. Just like kind of annoying to like try hard and like try to care about something that's like not really like being cared about. I pretty much was just like begging Aaron and Logan. I was like, we can do this. Like, there's no reason we can't. But I was like kind of like not really expecting it to really happen. I was just like, it would be sick. Because we can right now. The main product is like skateboarding, and that's like what I like, and that's what my friends like. You kind of just get to like throw a bunch of shit that you and your friends are into one brand and company. I mean, obviously, try to make other people like it too. Ultimately, you just get to like put shit out there that you and your friends are into, you know? Being a skateboarder is pretty demanding too, you know? It's like, it's, you don't want to be like 1 foot half in one thing, 1 foot half in the other. I don't know, it's all about finding a balance, I guess, which, like, I don't know. I haven't found it yet. I've just been hurt working on the computer and, like, drawing a little bit and, like, trying to, like, come up with ideas. I think about, that's, like, so lucky to be able to do, so I try to, like, just be hyped on it, you know. I just want to keep skating. I don't want anyone to think that I'm, like, trying to be an artist, you know. Mm-hmm. I just want to, like, maintain the company and hopefully just, like, get somebody else to make graphics eventually. Mm-hmm. But I'm just doing it right now. I definitely have been wanting to, like, diversify, but at the same time not be, like, not slack skating, because I feel like I still, like, have more shit I want to do. And because it really fucking sucks when you can't skate, and it really sucks when you can't get exercise. Sitting around on the computer every day is not good. It feels like shit, you know? And, like, I was on crutches for 7 weeks, and this is all I did, and it just, like, you feel nauseous, you get headaches, you feel gross. Your back hurts. Your crib.
Damn, I just got out of work. What's up?
Oh, you're in the city.
Okay, maybe see you later then, I guess.
Yeah, I'll hit you when I'm back. We'll be there. I'm just gonna be out there for like a couple hours. We're out here in Flushing Meadows. Beautiful day, it was really hot, and now it's winding down. It's 8 o'clock. Still light out though. Party out here. Bunch of little kids scootering and shit. Yeah, I just want to film some parts now that I feel better. And I feel like I can skate again, so it's great. And I think that's a possibility to get some parts going. I've already started, so I'm hyped. A lot of, like, the weird bullshit I was freaking out about disappeared once I could start skating again. It was a learning experience, you know. I'd never really been like that laid up. It was cool. I'm glad it's, like, over, though, obviously. Like, I take it for what it is. It's like, a lot of people get hurt and, like, try not to get super down, but it is fucking, it's weird.